The government's mission to deliver Brexit is on track, says Stephen Pollard. Turn on the TV or radio news and you'd be forgiven for thinking that Brexit is in chaos with ministers rowing, civil servants mutinying, the Prime Minister hold below the waterline and no one with. Day in, day out we're fed a diet of such stories, all of which have one unifying theme. Brexit is a disaster and we're crashing headfirst towards it. Strip away the spin and the hot air, the product of the Remainers' continuing refusal to accept the result of last year's referendum, and a very different story emerges. There is a plan. The cabinet has been agreed on it since it was first put together, and we are moving purposefully and sensibly towards leaving the EU in March 2019. Take yesterday's position paper on how customs might work after Brexit. It's an interesting document, proposing a number of practical ideas that would minimize any disruption after leaving, to judge from some of the commentary on it. However, it was something altogether different, the result of a cabinet battle in which the Remainer Chancellor Philip Hammond emerged victorious over the Leavers. To describe such an analysis as nonsense credits it with more sense than it deserves. Anyone who has paid attention to what has actually been happening will see that yesterday's position paper, the same will be true of the other similar documents that will follow. It is simply a small fleshing out of some of the details in the overall plan for Brexit, because, yes, there is a plan. A detailed and clear plan that was revealed with much fanfare by Theresa May in Lancaster House in January. And that plan has been the guide to pretty much everything that has followed since. The cabinet supports it, ministers support it, and it will deliver the Brexit that we voted for last year. The Lancaster House plan outlined 12 points, including control of our own laws, no hard border in Ireland, control of immigration to Britain from Europe, guaranteeing the rights of EU nationals in Britain, a bold and ambitious free trade agreement with the European Union, new trade deals with the rest of the world, and a smooth, orderly Brexit to protect business from a cliff edge through a phased process of implementation. Anyone, including of course the European Commission, can read the whole thing online at plaforbritai.gov.uk. It's all there. It's all public. And it's all been stuck to so far as it will be stuck to over the coming months of negotiations. Take the transition period mentioned in the position paper, which is the battle supposedly won by the Chancellor. According to these reports, cunning Philip Hammond outwitted the likes of David Davis and Liam Fox by pushing for a transition period, a limited time after we leave the EU in 2019, in which we will still be a member of a newly minted customs union, to give business extra time to adjust to the new post-Brexit arrangements. Again, pure nonsense. This is exactly what Mrs. May referred to in her Lancaster House speech when she spoke of a phased process of implementation. She could hardly have been any clearer, going into it in some detail. This might be about our immigration controls, customs systems, or the way in which we cooperate on criminal justice matters. Or it might be about the future legal and regulatory framework for financial services. For each issue, the time we need to phase in the new arrangements may differ. Some might be introduced very quickly, some might take longer. And the interim arrangements we rely upon are likely to be a matter of negotiation. But the purpose is clear: we will seek to avoid a disruptive cliff edge, and we will do everything we can to phase in the new arrangements we require as Britain and the EU move towards our new partnership. So much for the transition period being a newly won victory for Philip Hammond. It's certainly true that some Remainers would like to abuse the idea of a transition period to turn it into a permanent form of semi-membership of the EU. But that's a very different idea, which has to be resisted, and there is not a shred of evidence that Mr. Hammond holds that view. Quite the opposite, as he has been explicit about the need for a short, clear transition period. Not that anyone should be surprised by Remainer mischief making. That is after all what they are about. They want to derail Brexit. but they fool no one and certainly not the European Commission, which yesterday welcomed the government's latest step in the negotiations. We see the UK's publication of a series of position papers as a positive step towards now really starting phase one of the negotiations. The clock is ticking and this will allow us to make progress. Here's my advice, ignore all the spin, ignore the Remainers' defeatism and ignore their desperation to stop Brexit. Focus instead on the big picture, that we are leaving the EU in March 2019. Yes, there will be hiccups. No negotiation is ever without problems, but we have our plan, we have a willing negotiating partner, we have ministers out in the rest of the world preparing to do trade deals when we get the green light, we have allies looking forward to reaching deals and we have a government that is committed to delivering a proper Brexit. Thanks for watching, please like, share and don't forget to subscribe English News Hub for new excited videos.